Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're diving into one of the most fascinating and controversial topics in the world of health, biohacking, and productivity. Nootropics, also known as smart drugs. You've probably seen them in movies like Limitless, or heard entrepreneurs, students, and even CEOs swear by them. But what are nootropics really? Do they actually boost your brain power, or is it all just hype? And most importantly, are they safe? Stick around, because we're breaking it all down. No BS, no jargon, just the real science, the truth, and what you need to know before you ever pop a so-called smart pill. Let's go. What are nootropics? Let's dive into the fascinating world of nootropics, also known as smart drugs or cognitive enhancers. At their core, nootropics are substances, either natural or synthetic, that are believed to improve mental functions such as memory, focus, creativity, motivation, clarity, and mood. Whether you're a student studying for finals, an entrepreneur juggling a hectic schedule, or someone looking to reduce brain fog and feel more mentally sharp, the promise of nootropics is incredibly appealing. The term nootropic was coined in 1972 by Romanian psychologist and chemist Dr. Corneliu Georgiou, who defined it using several key criteria. According to him, a true nootropic should enhance learning and memory, facilitate communication between brain hemispheres, protect the brain from physical or chemical injuries, improve resistance to stress, have very few or no side effects. The word itself comes from two Greek roots, nous, meaning mind, trepen, meaning to bend or turn. So essentially, nootropics are tools that help steer or bend the mind in a more optimal direction. But here's the kicker. Not all nootropics are created equal. Some are well-researched and have a proven track record. Others exist in a gray area, sold as supplements with bold claims but little clinical evidence to back them up. Nootropics range from simple, well-known substances like caffeine, which most of us consume daily, to more complex synthetic compounds developed for military use or clinical research. Some are fast-acting stimulants. Others work subtly over time to support brain health and neurological performance. In today's high-performance culture, where productivity and creativity are prized, nootropics have become a hot topic, not just in health and wellness circles, but also among tech entrepreneurs, athletes, executives, and even biohackers. But before diving into whether they actually work, it's important to understand the different types out there. Categories of nootropics. Let's break nootropics down into three major categories, each with its own unique benefits and risks. 1. Natural nootropics. These are derived from herbs, plants, fungi, and natural compounds. Many have been used for centuries in traditional medicine systems, like Ayurveda and traditional Chinese medicine. Here are some of the most popular. Bacopa monnieri, an herb used for thousands of years in Ayurvedic medicine to enhance memory, reduce anxiety, and support learning. It works by boosting neuron communication and supporting brain regeneration. Rhodiola rosea, an adaptogenic herb that helps your body cope with stress, known to improve stamina, reduce fatigue, and enhance cognitive function under pressure. Lion's mane mushroom, a powerful fungus that stimulates the production of nerve growth factor, NGF, which supports brain cell regeneration and neuroplasticity. It may help with focus, memory, and long-term brain health. Ginkgo biloba, one of the oldest living tree species, known to increase blood flow to the brain and improve memory and attention span. L-theanine. Found naturally in green tea, L-theanine promotes calm alertness without sedation. It's often paired with caffeine to enhance focus without the crash or jitters. Natural nootropics tend to be gentle and long-lasting. They usually have fewer side effects and are a good starting point for anyone new to cognitive enhancement. 2. Synthetic nootropics. These are lab-created compounds specifically designed to boost brain function. They're more potent, but can also come with higher risks or legal restrictions. Modafinil, originally developed to treat narcolepsy, Modafinil is now a favorite among students, shift workers, and Silicon Valley professionals for its ability to promote sustained wakefulness and focus. It's not technically a stimulant, but has stimulant-like effects. Some even call it the real-life limitless pill. Racetams, a family of compound that includes pyrocetam, aniracetam, and oxyracetam. These are said to improve learning, memory, and cognitive processing. While widely used in the nootropic community, clinical evidence is still catching up. Nopeptide, a synthetic peptide that works similarly to Racetams, but is much more potent at lower doses. It's believed to support learning and memory while reducing anxiety. Synthetic nootropics can be effective, but they should be approached with caution. Many are not approved by the FDA for general use, and availability varies depending on your country. Always consult a medical professional before using them, especially long-term. 3. Everyday nootropics. Believe it or not, you may already be using nootropics in your daily routine without even realizing it. Caffeine plus L-theanine, a powerful combination that enhances alertness and attention without the typical caffeine jitters. It's one of the most studied and accessible nootropic stacks. Omega-3 fatty acids, EPA and DHA. Found in fish oil, these are essential for maintaining the structure and function of brain cells. They've been linked to improve mood, memory, and focus. Creatine. Commonly known as a fitness supplement, creatine also supports brain energy metabolism. It has been shown to improve reasoning, short-term memory, and mental fatigue, especially in vegetarians and older adults. These substances are generally safe, widely available, and have research-backed cognitive benefits. They're a great way to dip your toes into the world of brain optimization. Do nootropics actually work? Okay, so here's the million-dollar question. Do they really work? The research is mixed. Some natural nootropics have solid studies behind them. Bacopa, for example, has shown measurable improvement in memory recall, but only after consistent use for 8 to 12 weeks. Caffeine and L-theanine together? Multiple studies confirm improved focus, reaction time, and attention. Modafinil is widely accepted in scientific communities to increase alertness and cognitive performance, especially in sleep-deprived individuals. But effects can be highly individual. What works for one brain might do nothing for another. Many nootropics need long-term, consistent use to see results. There's no magic pill. Some studies show only small or temporary improvements in cognition. So yes, some nootropics do work, but it's not like flipping a switch. It's more like tuning an instrument. Risks, side effects, and safety. This is the part people don't always want to talk about, but we have to. While some nootropics are generally safe, others come with serious caveats. Modafinil can cause headaches, insomnia, anxiety, and dependence if misused. Racetams are unregulated in some countries. Hard to access quality, safe versions. Mixing supplements without understanding interactions can be dangerous. Even herbal supplements like ginkgo can affect blood pressure or interact with medications, bottom line. If you're considering nootropics, start with natural options. Avoid stacks that mix 10 plus ingredients unless you fully understand them. Talk to a healthcare provider before taking anything synthetic or strong. Smart drugs are only smart when you use them smartly. How to start safely. If you're curious and want to explore nootropics safely, here's a simple step-by-step. Identify your goal. Do you want better focus, less brain fog, improved memory? Tailor your choice accordingly. Start with the basics: caffeine plus L-theanine omega-3, S-creatine rhodiola, or Bacopa. Use one at a time. Don't start a full nootropic stack. Introduce one, wait 1-2 weeks, observe the effects. Track your results. Use a journal to track focus, energy, sleep, and mood. Adjust slowly. If something works, great. If it doesn't, no need to push through side effects. Nootropics are about enhancement, not dependence. Nootropics are a fascinating world. They're not a shortcut to genius, but when used wisely, they can give you an edge in focus, clarity, and calm, especially when combined with the fundamentals: sleep, nutrition, movement, and mindset. If you're feeling curious, start slow, stay smart, and don't forget, your brain is already powerful. Nootropics are just one tool in your toolbox. If you want me to review specific nootropic brands or stacks, drop a comment below. And if you learned something today, give the video a thumbs up and subscribe for more science-backed insights on how to level up your mind and body. Thanks for watching. Stay sharp, and I'll see you in the next one.